Good morning, everyone. Today we will discuss the concept of null type recorder. So in null type recorder, this is also one of the type of strip chart recorder. So first we'll discuss the working principle of null type recorder. The null type strip chart recorder works on the principle of null condition or self balancing. Next we'll move on to the types of null type recorder. There are three types: potentiometric, bridge and LVDT. So first we'll discuss the concept of potentiometric recorder. So this is the diagrammatic representation of potentiometric recorder. There are two diagrams. So in first figure, basic circuit of potentiometric recorder, and second figure, the block diagram of potentiometric recorder. By using these diagrams, we'll discuss the construction and working of potentiometric recorder. So first point, the input signal is compared with the reference voltage using potentiometric circuit. Second point, the difference between them is error signal, which is amplified and is used to analyze the field coil of DC motor. Third point, this DC motor is connected such that it turns in a direction that rotates the voltage divider arm in the direction that reduces the error. As the error becomes smaller, the motor slows down and finally stops at the point where error is zero, thus producing null balance. This is achieved by mechanically connecting the wiper or variable arm to the armature of the DC motor. The pen is also mechanically connected to the wiper. Hence, the wiper moves in a particular direction. The pen also moves in synchronism in the same direction, thereby recording the input waveform. The recorder has high input impedance and sensitivity. These recorders are mostly used for recording and control process of temperature. So next we'll move on to the bridge type recorder. So this is the diagram of bridge type recorder. By using this diagram, we will discuss the construction and working of bridge type recorder. So in construction and working, first point, thermistors are used a part of bridge circuit for measurement of temperature. Second point, it converts changes in temperature into variation in resistance by using thermistor. Third point, the resistor changes in the thermistor cause corresponding change in bridge output. These changes are applied to the detector. Fourth point, the bridge balance can be restored by varying the resistance of the another arm of the bridge. Fifth point, while recording in terms of current, voltage or temperature, depending on the kind of the voltage supplied to the bridge, the output can be chosen to be DC or AC. Thank you.